स्टूडेंट्स, माय नेम इज मिनी सेठी। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट कोव डगलस प्रोडक्शन फंक्शन। दिस प्रोडक्शन फंक्शन इज बेस्ड ऑन एम्पिरिकल स्टडी ऑफ अमेरिकन मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इंडस्ट्री एंड दिस स्टडी इज डन बाय पॉल एच डगलस एंड सी डब्ल्यू कोव। दिस प्रोडक्शन फंक्शन इज बेस्ड ऑन एम्पिरिकल स्टडी ऑफ अमेरिकन मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इंडस्ट्री एंड दिस स्टडी इज डन बाय पॉल एच डगलस एंड सी डब्ल्यू कोव। ओके, दिस प्रोडक्शन फंक्शन बेसिकली डिस्क्राइब टेक्निकल रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन अमाउंट ऑफ इनपुट एंड अमाउंट ऑफ आउटपुट। ओके, दिस प्रोडक्शन फंक्शन बेसिकली डिस्क्राइब टेक्निकल रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन अमाउंट ऑफ इनपुट एंड अमाउंट ऑफ आउटपुट। मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग, दिस प्रोडक्शन फंक्शन टेक्स ओनली टू इनपुट, लेबर एंड कैपिटल फॉर होल प्रोडक्शन। ओके, दिस प्रोडक्शन फंक्शन ओनली टेक्स टू इनपुट, लेबर एंड कैपिटल फॉर होल प्रोडक्शन। ओके, एंड इक्वेशन ऑफ दिस प्रोडक्शन फंक्शन इज दिस। ओके, क्यू इक्वल टू ए एल टू द पावर एल्फा एंड के टू द पावर बीटा। ओके, और यू कैन से दैट ए एल टू द पावर एल्फा एंड के टू द पावर वन माइनस एल्फा। सम बुक यू विल सी दिस इक्वेशन ए एल टू द पावर एल्फा एंड के टू द पावर बीटा। इन सम बुक यू विल सी दिस इक्वेशन ए एल टू द पावर एल्फा एंड के टू द पावर वन माइनस एल्फा। मीनिंग ऑफ बोथ इक्वेशन इज सेम, डोंट बी कन्फ्यूज। ओके, आइदर यू कैन राइट ए एल टू द पावर एल्फा और के टू द पावर बीटा, और यू कैन राइट ए एल टू द पावर एल्फा और के टू द पावर वन माइनस एल्फा। ओके, मीनिंग ऑफ बोथ इक्वेशन इज सेम। ओके, and what is q in this equation? Q is your output, l is your labor, k is your capital. Okay, and alpha is output elasticity for labor, alpha is output elasticity for labor, and beta is output elasticity for capital, beta is output elasticity for capital. Okay, and a is all factor productivity, or you can say that a is total factor productivity which depend on technology, and a is constant in this production function. Okay, a is all factor productivity, or you can say that total factor productivity which depend on technology, and a is constant in this production function. Okay, and most important thing, this production function is based on linear homogeneous production function. Okay, what does mean of linear homogeneous production function? Linear homogeneous production function is means constant return to scale. What does mean of constant return to scale? Constant return to scale means when a firm change their input, it will occur exactly same change in amount of output. Okay, if a firm change their input, it will occur exactly same amount of change in their output. For example, if a firm increase 15% in their input, then their output will also increase 15%. Means exactly same change in output when firm change their input. Okay, we will understand constant return to scale with the help of this diagram. In x axis we take labor, in y axis we take capital. Okay, when firm applying 2 labor and 2 capital, total output is 50. When firm double their input, okay, now firm is applying 4 amount of labor and 4 amount of capital. When firm double their input, as we see earlier firm were applying 2 labor and 2 capital, now firm is applying 4 labor and 4 capital, output also double. Earlier output was 50, when firm double their input, output will also double. Earlier output was 50, now output is 100. Okay, means when firm change their input, there will occur same amount of change in their output. It's called constant return to scale. Okay, but how can we know we are getting constant return to scale from this production function? Because Cobb Douglas production function is based on this equation, na? But how can we know from this equation we are getting constant return to scale or not? Okay, we can know about this information we are getting constant return to scale or not with value of alpha and beta. If alpha and beta is equal to 1, means we are getting constant return to scale. Listen carefully. If alpha plus beta is equal to 1, means we are getting constant return to scale. For example, here we take alpha value is 3 over 4. This is same equation. AL to the power alpha K, K to the power beta, as we earlier discussed here. Okay. We take alpha value is 3 over 4 and beta value is 1 over 4. If we add this both value, this will be equal to 1. Okay. If we add both this value, it will be equal to 1. Means if alpha plus beta is equal to 1, we are getting constant return to scale. Okay. And in this equation, we can know that labor contribution in production function is 75% and capital contribution is 25%. Okay, if alpha plus beta is greater than 1, means we are getting increasing return to scale. If alpha plus beta less than 1, we are getting decreasing return to scale. Okay, if alpha plus beta is equal to 1, means we are getting constant return to scale. Okay, if alpha plus beta is greater than 1, means we are getting increasing return to scale. If alpha plus beta is less than 1, means we are getting decreasing return to scale. But Cobb Douglas production is based on linear homogeneous production function, means constant return to scale. How can we know we are getting constant return to scale? If alpha plus beta is equal to 1. Okay, now we will calculate average product by using this equation. Okay, this is equation of total product, total output. Okay, we will calculate average product and marginal product by using this equation. Okay, what is formula of average product? Average product formula is Q over L. As we know, average product formula is Q over L. Okay, we simply put value of Q here. Okay, we simply put value of Q here. What is value of Q? I earlier discussed about that. Both equation are same. Either you can write this equation, either you can write this equation. Meaning of both equation is same. Okay. In some book, write this equation. In some book, write this equation. Meaning of both equation is same. Okay. Now I will calculate average product by using this equation. Okay. This is equation of total product, total output. Okay. By using this equation, I will calculate average product and marginal product. Firstly, I will calculate average, then marginal. Okay, and both meaning of both equation is same. As I earlier discussed, we can write either this equation or this equation. Meaning of both equation is same. Okay, formula of average product is Q over L. I simply put the value of Q. Value of Q is this one. A L to the power alpha and K to the power 1 minus alpha. Okay. This lower L has no power, so its power will be 1. This lower L has no power, so this lower L will power is equal to 1. Okay, if we take this alpha to the this L to the power alpha below, it will become L to the power 1 minus alpha. Simply I do this. L to the power alpha below, it will become L to the power 1 minus alpha. Okay, and our final equation is we will take common, K over L take common, and to the power is 1 minus alpha. Okay, and our final equation is A into K over L to the power 1 minus alpha. This is our final value of average product. Okay, now I will calculate marginal product. Okay, for marginal product of this equation. Okay, I earlier discussed this is equation of total output. Firstly, I calculate average product by using this equation. Now I will calculate marginal product by using this same equation. Okay, for calculating marginal product, I will do differentiation. Okay, for calculating marginal product, I will do differentiation. Okay, with respect to L. Okay, we will do differentiation with respect to L because we want to calculate marginal product of labor. Okay, when we do differentiation with respect to L, there will be dQ over dL. Okay, most important thing. This A is constant. As I earlier discussed, this A is all factor productivity or total factor productivity. We depend on technology is constant. We never do differentiation of constant variable. Okay, so this variable will remain as it is. Okay, after doing differentiation of A L to the power alpha, it become A अल्फा एल टू द पावर अल्फा माइनस वन. लिसन केयरफुली, आफ्टर डूइंग डिफरेंशिएशन ए एल टू द पावर अल्फा इट बिकम ए अल्फा एल टू द पावर अल्फा माइनस वन. ओके, इट विल रिमेन सेम. ओके, now as I earlier discussed, a is constant, we will not do differentiation of a. okay, what do you mean by l power alpha minus 1? okay, l power alpha minus 1 mean it consists l to the power alpha and l to the power minus 1. l to the power alpha minus 1 means it consists l to the power alpha and l to the power minus 1. If we take this l to the power minus 1 below, it will become like that. If we take l to the power minus 1 below, it will become like that. Okay, our equation is a alpha l to the power alpha k to the power 1 minus alpha over l to the power 1. Okay, now we will minus upper and lower with alpha. We will minus upper and lower with alpha. Now it become a alpha l to the power alpha minus 1 k to the power 1 minus alpha over l to the power 1 minus alpha. This alpha and this alpha will cut with each other, okay, will cancel with each other, okay, and this l will become 1, and our final equation is a alpha into k over l to the power 1 minus alpha. This is our final equation. We take common k over alpha and 1 minus alpha outside. This will become our final equation of marginal product. Firstly, we calculate average product, and now we calculate marginal product. Okay, I think you understand. Thank you.